Good morning, Spanish River. I'm Daisy Chaskin. These are your Thursday, April 9th morning announcements. I hope that everybody's staying safe and practicing social distancing. Have a great day. And now on to Melissa and Sander.
Thanks, Daisy. I'm Melissa.
And I'm Sander.
We hope you are staying safe during these times and enjoy our Throwback Thursday announcements. Now on to the pledge.
And guess who's back? Back again. Nico and Harrison at the desk.
Please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated.
Obi Trice, real name, no gimmicks.
Two trailer park girls go round the outside, round the outside, round the outside. Two trailer park girls. Go round the outside, round the outside, round the outside.
Guess who's back, back, back again. Shady's back, tell a friend. Guess who's back, 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 guess who's back.
Good morning, Spanish River. Happy Throwback Thursday. Welcome to WSRH on digital, wherever you may be watching. My name is Harrison.
My name is Nico.
And we're going to try to mix things around a little bit today. We got some short announcements. We're going to read you some news. Then we're going to bring on a couple of guests to interview, including ace travel and tourism teacher, Miss Burke, and the host with the most. Tyrese Moreau-Pinard, our WSRH colleague, going to bring it on, asking them a few questions about coronavirus, their lives right now. But first, on to Nico with some yearbook information.
If you didn't pre-order your 2020 Tim Brown yearbook, well, no need to worry. Yearbooks are back on sale at www.yearbookordercenter.com. This is the only way to get a guaranteed copy of the yearbook, so log on and order yours today. Now on to Harrison.
Do you want to be a leader of our school? Do you like planning things like homecoming, spring fling, and virtual spirit weeks? Then you should apply to be in the SGA leadership class. Applications are online on the school website. Go to SpanishRiverHS.org and scroll to the bottom. The link to the application will be on the left side. All applications are due out on Monday, April 17th at 7 p.m. The form will no longer be active after that time on the 7th or on the 13th at 7 p.m., April 13th. Now back to Nico.
Seniors, if you have your fully completed community service forms, with related documentation can be sent to mara.gorin@palmbeachschools.org and will be processed within a week time of being sent. Questions can be emailed to Ms. Gorin. Get them in for your graduation requirement. Now on to Harrison.
Parents and students, refunds for Grad Bash have been issued at this time. Please allow between 7 to 10 days to the credit to reflect on your credit card statement. We are diligently working on prompt refunds and greatly appreciate your patience. Okay, we now bring on a two-time Teacher of the Month, ace travel and tourism teacher, Miss Burke.
Yeah.
We're glad you're here and we're glad you made it. Welcome to WSRH Digital. How are you today?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm doing good. Tell us a little about your last few weeks with social distancing and quarantine.
Well, we've been taking it really serious here at the Burke House. We have not left our own little neighborhood in weeks, but it's a lot of family time, but we're doing pretty good.
Yeah. And how is it as a teacher adjusting from outside of the classroom, taking on a whole new world of your, I guess, working digitally with Zoom and Google Meet? And tell us about adjusting to the teaching online learning.
Well, there's definitely a learning curve. Before we even started, I spent lots of time going online and learning myself what the best way to figure it all out is. And I think everybody's had a steep learning curve, right? We sink or swim. And I'm a Burke, so I definitely swim.
Yes. Also the varsity water polo coach, Miss Burke. And your season got cut short there. Anything you want to talk about that?
Well, I can tell you with certainty, and all the kids that were in practice with us, we were getting better and better each game. So to see the season shortened is a disappointment. But next year,
Gotta watch out. And
watch out.
Yeah.
You'll search me all over that. And since you are an ACE travel teacher, tell us about the expert knowledge that you have about the coronavirus and how it's affecting really the entire travel industry and affecting individual travelers and even our own Spanish River students.
Sure. Well, it's definitely affected everybody, and we are living through historic moments. We can see so clearly now that travel and tourism affects the whole world and world economies. So it's almost like what we're learning in our classroom, ACE Travel and Tourism, and Nico and Harrison have been both my students. And, you know, it gets no clearer than today, and watching airplanes, 271 airplanes usually land at JFK daily. They're down to 13 airplanes every day now. So it's a huge, huge change in New York's financial situation, and it's a ripple effect around the world.
Yeah, I know. I, along with Anigo, also had travel plans for spring break and that are now being canceled or postponed or unaffected. So how is that affecting really, I guess, teenagers at that level of coronavirus?
Right. Well, we're all feeling it, right? So we're all disappointed to some degree of an activity or event that we were going to participate in. And it's maybe you're going to save a few dollars and have a few less memories in that department, but you're also gaining something too. So don't always look at what you're missing.
Yeah, that's very important. Look at the bright side of all of this. I know, finding new things to do while you're here in your home. And finally, because it's Throwback Thursday here on WSRH, tell us about one of your oldest, best memories from Spanish River.
My oldest, best memories? I remember my very, very first day at Spanish River, and I was young and excited, and I got a little overwhelmed. So I sat in the courtyard right in front of the shark shop on one of those park benches, and I cried. I was like, oh my gosh, this is just so much. But over the years, it's become my second home, and I miss it very much. And I miss all of you so much.
I think it worked out well for you after that first
time.
And when I first emailed you about this whole doing the interview, you said to go easy on you. Did you think we did well?
You guys are the best. I look forward to your morning announcements and all of WSRH every day.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We appreciate having Ms. Burke on. If we were to do this again in the near future, we'll be sure to bring you back and ask some more questions. So thank you, Ms. Burke, for coming on.
My pleasure. Have a great day.
We now bring on our WSRH colleague, Tyrese. Tyrese, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing just fine. Tell us a little bit about your last few weeks out of school with your quarantine, your social distancing.
I've been trying to keep myself busy, a lot of sleep, a lot of work, actually. Not very much going on over here.
And let's get the students' perspective of what this online digital learning transformation from what we've been doing at school to now this. Do you like it, not like it? Tell us about
It's not my favorite. I feel like it's more work than actually going to school, but, you know, we're getting
busy work.
We're learning, and I guess that's all that matters at the end of the day.
Yep. We got about 4 weeks until potential graduation or the last day of school. What are your thoughts on a potential digital graduation, the cancellation of prom?
Graduation is graduation. I'm looking forward to it.
I'd
rather have it in person, but, you know.
You still think there's a chance we have an in-person graduation?
Keep my fingers crossed. I hope that there is a chance, but, you know, hopefully this thing gets better. I feel like there is a slim chance, yeah.
Yep. And let's move on to a little bit more about yourself. Tyrese, you're going to Florida State. Is that – that's what the rumor on the rumor mill. Is that true?
Yeah.
All right. So Florida State basketball, great season. Unfortunately, came a little short. What do you think on that?
Florida State, I'm excited to go to Tallahassee, change of scenery. They got a lot of good sports programs there, so.
Football team, you know?
Yeah, I might. I don't know.
All right, Nico, anything to add on? Nico loves Florida State, isn't that right?
What?
Oh, you think not paying attention in the interview?
Yeah.
Nico, what's in the cup? Let's hear that one.
Water.
Tyrese, ask Nico a question.
Nico, man, so what have you been doing to keep yourself busy during quarantine?
Oh, I painted my pool deck. That was a big one. I cleaned all my windows.
Mm. All right, Tyrese. Yeah. Anything further you want to add before we sign you off?
I hope everybody stays safe, man. Get all your online work turned in. Just keep yourself busy and wear your badges, of course.
Of course, always wear your badge. I'm going to go put on mine right now, actually.
Yeah, I actually can't find mine, so.
Yeah, always mine might be.
Shark and wear your badge. Always wearing mine. All right, thank you so much, Tyrese, for coming on. If we do this
of course, again, in the garbage. Back.
Pleasure.
Yeah, let's take Tyrese off.
Bye, Tyrese.
All right, and so thanks, everyone, for joining us today on WSRH. If you like the interview style, we'll be sure to bring this back in the next few weeks. Remember, tune in into the video for the Throwback Thursday to see your teachers, what they look like before now, I guess, is the phrasing. So
a that is correct.
Back to their high school and younger days is the correct terminology I should be saying. Now, check out that video. Have a great week. Continue up with the hard works. Be a shark. Wear your badge, as always. Thank you so much. We'll see you next time on WSRH.
Welcome back. These are Shark Birthdays, the home edition. I'm Evan, and let's go ahead and get it started. So, I don't remember exactly where we left off. So, we'll just go ahead and start off with Miss K's birthday was March 9th. Happy birthday to her. Then on the 10th, we have Miss Pajowski. Then on the 16th, we have Mr. David Rory. He's the head custodian at school. Shout out to him. And then we have Mr. Deacon on the 23rd, or was on the 23rd, excuse me. And then on March 25th, we had Miss London. And then on March 28th, we had Miss Abreu. March 30th was Miss Daninos. April 1st, it was Miss Summer. On the April 4th was my guy, Mr. Vargas. Happy birthday to him. Then on April 9th, we have Miss Gorin. And then on April 14th, it is Miss McGulick. On April 17th, it is Miss Boyer. Sorry if I mispronounce your name. And then on the 18th is Miss Denise Kabaj. And on the 19th is Miss Eames. Happy birthday to all of our teachers and staff. Also, we had our own WSRH senior, previously have a birthday, Jillian Delaney. Happy birthday to her. And then I also wanted to shout out Miss Yoder and Miss Siegel for working very hard the last few weeks on getting Chromebooks out to all the students and teachers, as well as making old laptops into Chromebooks. It was a big challenge and in a very short amount of time. So shout out to both of them for doing a great job, as well as the administration helping and making things go smooth. With that being said, I will see you all next time. Take care.